and welcome to this week's edition of WCS Sports Connection. I'm your co-host, Jimmy Qualls, and with me, as always, is the talent of the room, Tate Mathews. Tate, let's talk
cheap
about...
Cheap talent.
Do what?
Cheap talent.
Cheap talent. Let's talk about wrestling real quick before we get into the basketball, because basketball is winding down. Great action. District tournament starting. Man, this is my favorite time of the year. But in the wrestling world, individual state tournament, TAA, is starting this week. It's at the Ag Pavilion on Friday and Saturday. We have a total of 54 wrestlers going. That breaks last year's record of 47.
Yeah, impressive. It's going to be fun. It actually starts on Thursday, but it'll be Thursday, Friday, Saturday over there. We're well represented. It's going to be neat. All the teams, I believe, got somebody in. So it's going to be exciting. The girls are well represented on both sides. So, and I think we got quite a few guys who stand a chance to. We'll have a lot of medalists, but I think we got a few guys that stand a chance to win a state championship. That'd be really neat.
Well, I know that on top of my head, Paige broke their own school record with eight individuals that'll be going to that particular tournament. It's the most in school history that's ever represented Page High School in the TAA State Championships. It's going to be fantastic. Best of luck to all those. We have spring sports starting this week. It's hard to believe. Baseball, softball, track and field, men's soccer, all on top of us.
Yeah, it's here, man, and overlap right now. And then, you know, basketball's still going on too. So a lot to – and then right around the corner will be spring football, so it's hard to believe we're already talking about that. But you mentioned Page. They've had a lot of firsts this year. They broke their – most wins and dual record school history ever. You mentioned they've got the most individual qualifiers for the state tournament they've ever had. They finished third in the duels, and so I know we've talked a lot about it, but the job Coach Gray's done there is unbelievable, man. That program was literally on life support before he got there. I mean, he has done an unbelievable job.
Think about this. Benji Gray and the Pats will be joining the Big Six next year when it goes to the wrestling. You're talking about now you're going Peter Miller of Summit High School, Jerry Grindstaff, Independence, all the way down the list, Joe Blair, Brentwood, all those guys that do a phenomenal job, Centennial. I mean, just go down the list.
Now, well, and Nolensville will be a year older. I mean, you know, they're freshman and sophomore, but Coach Peck, when he was at Ravenwood, they had a nice run. There was about a three-year run where Ravenwood was number one in the conference. So, yeah, no, it won't take Nolensville very long to catch up either.
So, wrestling state individual tournament beginning this week, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday at the Ag Pavilion. All right, basketball action, man. We finished on a flare. Crazy night, as always. Any given night in the WCS Sports Conference in basketball has been something to behold. Let's start on the girls' side. Girls, Brentwood right now, 7-19, 2-10. They lost to Franklin in a close one, 52-47. Lost to Dixon, 59-30, finishes number six seed. Coach Siegenthaler's group right now have been inching closer and closer to getting better at the finish line. Don't sleep on Brentwood right now. Could have an opportunity to play spoiler when we get into this 11 AAA district tournament.
Yeah, without a doubt. And all you have to do is look at, you know, it's been a tough season for them. Not a whole lot of wins. Definitely not a whole lot of district wins. But Summit sitting there in the number four seed. And that's one of their wins. So, right, I don't think anybody in this tournament can sleep on anybody. And that's really the role that they're going to take, and I think they're going to embrace it. That's where they are. So what can we do now? Let's go play the spoiler role in the district tournament, and they'll have a good week of practice, I would think, have a good plan. So, yeah, nobody can sleep on them in this tournament.
Intriguing matchup. You know, when it comes down to this particular stretch of games, matchups are the key. Centennial, Brentwood, just seems like to me that could be very interesting. I know Coach Hill, or matter of fact, none of the coaches will get any kind of sleep this week, but I'm telling you right now, that matchup, keep your eyes on it because I feel like that could be a possible spoiler alert. Brentwood right now going in as a number six seed. Centennial, 15-7, 9-3, lost to Franklin on Friday night in a thriller in overtime, 38-30 in the Battle of Franklin. They finished the number three seed. If Coach Hill was possibly to win that game, we're looking at a coin flip for first place, going to the region automatic bye on, you know, 50-50 shot with a coin flip. So you go from first, now you're into third, now you've got to regroup, get yourself back. So that's what I'm telling you. Watch this potential 3-6 matchup right here between Centennial and Brentwood. Chantel Fly, great player for Coach Hill, We've mentioned it numerous times on air that Centennial 15-7, 9-3 in the district. There's a lot of years they had, you know, several years combined they wouldn't have gotten to that many wins.
Yeah, last game of the season they have a chance for a tie of second place. So, and I think this is one that they kind of like. I agree with you on the matchups, and I think between Malia Robertson and Chantel Fly, I think that poses two matchup problems for Brentwood. So I think this is actually one of the ones Centennial would want to see. But you're the basketball expert. But yeah, 15-7, man, that's a heck of a year. And I don't think they're done.
On the other side of the battle, Franklin, you have Coach Barnwell and the Franklin Lady Rebels, 18-8, 9-3 in district play. They beat Brentwood 52-47 and Centennial 38-30 to finish the year out. They finished the number 2 seed. Coach Barnwell gets it done, comes in there in that number 2 slot. Very important that you get in that 2 slot just so you can have the confidence going in playing the last place team. It's probably, you don't want to say a sure thing, but it's the closest to a sure thing as you can get outside of being the number 1 spot. And Holly Harris, Jillian King, those are household names from Franklin Lady Rebels, WCS Sports Conference. That also leads us to our first out of 2 Play of the Weeks in the Battle of Franklin, Holly Harris to Jillian King.
She's heated up a bit here in the second. Didn't have anything going in the first. That one's taken away by Holly Harris. Dish over to King, and King off the window. Jillian King gives Franklin the lead back. Harris, your leading scorer for Franklin. She has 9, followed by King with 7.
Tate, anytime you talk about the Franklin Lady Rebels, you have to start with Holly Harris. Holly Harris makes it happen. She is the kind of the go-to person. I know Coach Barnwell talks about her quite a bit, but he also talks about Jillian King. But I feel like the Lady Rebels go and prosper as Holly Harris does.
Yeah, I would agree with that. And she's a talented young lady, junior, right? So got another year of her, but that, I would agree with that. When she's playing well, if she's in double figures, Franklin has a good chance to win. And I thought she was going to take that thing to the hole. But
nice little wraparound
that
pass.
That was a very nice pass, very impressive.
Sees the floor very well. And here's the thing.
She got that from her mother, not her father.
That's right. Ann Harris, also national champion at Louisiana Tech.
That's right.
Interesting thing about Holly's got good size, perfect size for a college 2, maybe squeeze at a 3 at a tweener, if you will. But she has great court vision, handles the ball well, shoots the ball well, has pretty good athletic ability. She's going to be able to be a really good player at the next level, regardless of what level she goes into. So the Lady Rebels right now sitting in a good spot, second seed in the 11 AAA tournament, and they will be facing who? They'll be facing the number 7 seed, Independence Lady Eagles, who finished the regular season 8-17, 1-11 in the district, lost to Dixon 37-35. They're right there knocking on the door. So this not a guarantee right now. If you go last place team playing the first place team and you only, the first place team escapes getting beat by 2 points, anything can happen right now. They're wanting to play spoiler in there. The matchups here, very intriguing as well. This is not a lopsided affair between these 2 teams.
No, all you got to do is look at the scores. They've gotten better all year long. They were able to knock off Brentwood and get a district win. Marybeth White, same thing as what Coach Sig will be doing at Brentwood. Let's play the spoiler alert. Let's get one more game under our belt, get one more win and advance to play one more tournament game. Who knows what will happen? So you're right. That 37-35 score at Dixon tells you everything you need to know. The Lady Eagles are better.
Ravenwood, Lady Raptors, Mariska Harris and crew, 13-13, 4-8. They've lost 4 in a row coming down the stretch here. They're kind of limping into the finish line, if you will. They lost to Summit 42-36. They finished number 5. They are in the ever-looming, the game that everybody wants to avoid. The 4-5 matchup is usually always the hardest game to win. You got your 2 closest teams, if you will, finishing out right there playing each other. One of those teams have to go home. Summit, Ravenwood, that will be played at Summit because Ravenwood is the 5 seed right now. Coach Harris has got to get her team mentally prepared for this. Like I said, they have kind of lost a little bit of things going on, 4 in a row. Kira down anytime she's on the floor, though. Very dangerous. I know that Coach Kerry Goodwin's looking at this matchup, looking at the past films. What are they going to do with Kiara Downey? How are they going to try to keep her one-dimensional? Best of luck with that.
Yeah, and congratulations to Kiara Downey. She became the school's the Lady Raptors' all-time leading scorer. I guess we knew that was going to happen at some point, but that's a big accomplishment for her. Nobody, no Lady Raptors ever scored more points than her, so congratulations to her. They got a turnaround play for the second time in less than 5 days. I think they played the game before that as well, so here they are, kind of like that Centennial Franklin football game a few years ago. I think they've played the last three games in a row, if I'm correct, if not two of the last three, 4 or 5. That's why that game Friday night, there's a lot of reasons why, but it was so big. Summit, Ravenwood, they both wanted to get it home. Summit got that win, and so they'll have to travel down to Spring Hill. And you're right, both these teams have changed. It seems like they've both changed a couple times during the year. So, you know, it's going to be hard to kind of game plan for them, but it's going to be a tough game. And, you know, you got to think it's going to come down to the very end.
Summit, Lady Spartans, 12-14, 7-5. We've talked about this all year. Now, they started off well below 500. Here they are in the district above, two games above, 500, 7-5. Beat Ravenwood 42-36. They finish as the number 4 seed in the District 11 AAA. So Coach Goodwin has to be feeling really good right now. Spartans coming in. I know she felt good about the win Friday night, but right now I'm not sure that I know how they are. No sleep, no food. I mean, this is one of those deals, man. It is going to be a grind of getting their teams ready, mentally prepared, walking on eggshells at this point in time, because then you start playing all the mind games. We've beaten them twice. We've split with them. They've beaten us. They beat us last game of the year, or we won the last game of the year. Are our kids going to think that we can automatically walk in there? Or, hey, they haven't won but one district game. How, you know, my kids are going to see that and they're going to automatically think. So all those mind games start being played by the coaches at this time of the year. Tate, let's do a recap of 11 AAA right now. The games will take place at the higher seed. We'll note that as we go down the list. The games begin Tuesday, February 14th, as the first round happens. Second round will happen on Friday. If you survive in advance this first round, Tate, all games will be played at Centennial. So right now, home court advantage goes to those higher seeds at the satellite sites. And here are the matchups beginning. These games will happen at 6 o'clock on Tuesday night, February 14th, at Summit. Number 4 seed Summit Lady Spartans will take on the number 5 Ravenwood Lady Raptors in the number 5 game. Would you like to talk about that game, Tate? Or
we just did, but you want me to pick? Is that what you're saying?
Let's move on down. We'll come back to it. Number 2, host Franklin Lady Rebels will host number 7 Independence Eagles. Number 3, Centennial Lady Cougars will host number 6 Brentwood. Now, number 1, Dixon gets the bye.
I think Dixon gets a win.
Dixon gets a win. They're automatically in the region. Whoever wins these region games get into the second round. Let's talk about it.
All right.
Pick'ems. Here we go. Who gets into the Final 4 off of these satellite games? Who will face Dixon in that second round, number 4 Summit or number 5 Ravenwood?
Summit, and I think it's going to be about a 42-36 game again.
I agree. It will come down to the wire. I'm going to agree with you right now. Lady Spartans feeling, playing a little better than things are happening, but I think this is a seriously close game.
It
may be an overtime game, very tight. Lady Spartans with the win there to face Dixon in the second round. Franklin, Independence.
Franklin, but close game.
I agree. I think Franklin right now, the Lady Rebels are playing really, really good. Are we going to disagree on anything? This is very rare, Mr.
Not
Producer.
The first round.
Centennial Lady Cougars versus Brentwood. Can Brentwood play spoiler on Centennial?
They can, but I don't think they do. I think Centennial will get the win. I just think they have. I think they win the matchup. Probably.
Lady Bruins, use this as motivation because I agree with him. Lady Cougars of Centennial advance. Chantel Fly, they're playing really good right now, despite having the loss. It sets up Battle of Franklin in round 2. And in Dixon versus Summit. Now, just for reminder to our viewers, that this round, the semifinal round, is all at Centennial High School, Friday, February 17th. The first game will be Dixon versus Summit. Number 1 seed, Dixon play Summit. Can Summit knock off Dixon?
Can? Yes. Do I think they will? No. I think Dixon wins.
Oh, unfortunately, I've never picked against anybody, but we've got to differ somewhere. So, Dick, I'm going to pick. I'm going to change my pick. Last
Old
second
Sparty.
Pick. Old Sparty right there. Beat
it.
Dixon, knock it off. Coach Kerry Goodwin and the Summit Lady Spartans right there. Knock off Dixon. Woo, Dixon,
it's big.
Dixon moving to the consolation bracket. All right, lower bracket. Battle of Franken, round three. This is a difficult one. Who do you have?
Came down to the last game. I think Centennial, they're on the home court. It came down to double overtime last time. There were 0 points scored in the first overtime. And in the second overtime, Franklin pulled away from him. I'm going home court advantage. I'm going with the Lady Cougars. And it's got to be the first time ever, if this happens, that the Lady Cougars have been in the district championship game of the tournament.
Pump the brakes on that, Tate. I know we've got home court advantage, but you just gave away the Achilles heel of why Franklin beat Centennial in this round. Franklin's got a little bit more experience in this. Centennial's still kind of finding their way. This loss will not be detrimental to Centennial, even though it puts them in a consolation game. They can learn from this, get ready for the region tournament, because championship game, Summit versus Franklin is who I have. You've got Dixon versus Centennial there.
Who do you have winning your championship game?
Well, I've got Summit Franklin. I did have another team there, but I'm going to go Summit Franklin. I'm going to go the winner of this is the champion, and I'm going to go the Franklin Lady Rebels in an upset over, I wouldn't call it an upset, but beating Summit in the championship game.
Centennial's going to make it to the championship game. That's a big deal. They'll be almost to 20 wins. But Dixon will be the district champion. I hope I'm wrong, but that's just, if I'm being honest, that's who I think wins.
More importantly, top four seeds moving on. Dixon, Franklin, Centennial, Summit. They'll fight it out to see who gets what in the region.
We agree on the top four, just not the order.
The Twitter storm is coming. Here they come. Let's talk real quick. Fairview Lady Jackets finished the season 3-23, 2-14. They lost to Hickman County 40-38 in a close one in the 8-9 playing game. The Fairview Yellow Jackets, like I said, young, have a really good couple players there. They're going to be moving up. And, you know, this is one of those situations that with growing pains, Coach Wayne McGowan's group can be a little better next year.
Yeah, without a doubt. And, you know, try to win this game, maybe get in and get one more. That's all you can do is keep building for the future. They are in it. I know we talk about this with all of our guys, but they really are in a tough district.
Lewis County right now sitting on top. Creekwood looking really good in that group as well. Page right now, 19-8. They have won 8 in a row. Coach Ron Brock feeling really good about the Lady Patriots. Beat Marshall County 45-33. Play Giles County on Tuesday night of this week to see who gets the coin flip for the state, for the berth to go into region, automatic bye, first place seed. This is a huge game. They've got to beat Giles County to get that. Page will also host a tournament. How big will that play down the road for them?
I think it'll be very, very big. And they've already beat CPA. They beat Franklin. I think they feel like they're confident they can beat Giles County. I think they feel like they think they can play with anybody.
They beat Giles County, win the coin toss, and win number one seed. That also gives them their 20th win. They have to be sitting really good right now, filling-wise, regardless of what happens.
Yes.
Get themselves in the tournament. They're hosting the tournament. Win the tournament, regardless of what happens, if they get into the coin toss or not. Best of luck, Lady Patriots. Nolensville, Lady Knights, 10-15, 3-8, beat Spring Hill, 82-69. Lost to Page, 45-33. Nolensville has to get themselves ready for the tournament. This will be a culture shock to the Lady Knights. Nothing against them. Great win. 10 wins for the season for freshmen and sophomores. But this time of the year is extremely tough if you've never experienced it.
Yeah, I would say you're right. But 10 wins, Coach Ladd, great job first year there. And it's also his first time coaching girls.
Go play spoiler. Go in there and get yourself. If they could get themselves a win and get themselves a region tournament, this would pay off so big for the next 2 years, because you got to get there to experience it, to know, to understand clock time management strategies, be mature enough to understand game field study, and do quick turnarounds on all the above to get themselves prepared for that run in the regional tournament. So I hope and wish them the best of luck, Coach Ladd and the Lady Knights. District 11 AAA boys, not a better basketball district anywhere, possibly outside of Shelby County.
And I don't think anybody outside of here would argue with you. You're right. This is the best, most competitive district, top to bottom in the entire state.
We have two currently sitting in the top 10 in the mid-state polls right now. Obviously, Summit sitting in number 7. They have fallen from number 2 to number 7. They're going to get themselves ready, mentally back in the saddle, if you will. Brentwood sitting at number 9 at 21-6, 8-4. Who would have thought Coach Shirley coming here last year? This is his second year. Brentwood Bruins sitting at 21 wins, 6 losses, 8-4 in the district. They've won 3 in a row after having a little bit of falter there, and that could have played off huge for them. Their falter came 2 weeks ago They lost a couple games in a row. They've gotten themselves back ready for tournament time, and I think that is crucial for them. Those losses sometimes help them out, but you also want to come in on some wins versus the losses, and that's exactly what's happened for the Brentwood Bruins. Won three in a row. They beat Franklin 68-54, and they beat Dixon 66-41. They have locked up the number two seed in 11 AAA.
Yep, they're playing with a lot of confidence right now. You're right. Kellen King is kind of their main man, you know, and he keeps seeming to be right around 20 points. And I think they're the most – I think they're the deepest team in the tournament. So, got to feel good about where they are
Reed right now. Smith right now. Pay attention to Reed Smith. Well. Christian LaBrèche playing really well. Thurman. Watch those guys, man. I'm telling you, they, you're right. They've got good size. They can shoot the ball. Heads up, I think they've learned a lesson in a few of those games late where they're trying to put the game in the freezer, if you will, and stall a little bit. What's a good shot? What's a bad shot? What to do? What not to do? Harry Lackey. Harry Lackey, freshman right now.
Diaper Dandy. Hey, one thing to remember about Brentwood, too, they were, and I'm assuming they still are, they're shooting over 80% from the free throw line as a team.
That's going to pay off.
That's going to pay off.
And you know what? If you go back to those couple games that they faltered, they may have – I think that they missed some pretty crucial free throws. Learn from those mistakes. Make those down the stretch. Continue shooting 80%. Things will work in your favor. Centennial, upset of the week, 6-18, 3-9, beat Franklin 65-61 in double overtime. They lock up the number six seed in Trey Carlton. Another diaper dandy freshman here at Centennial. From 30 feet to put the game into overtime right here, play of the week on the boys' side.
Second one's going to find the back of the iron. Here comes Centennial. Opportunity to tie. They need a three. Carlton will launch and connect. Saw it coming the whole way. Second overtime game, Trey Carlton. We'll tie this one up at 53-all. Trey Carlton canning it from about 30 feet away. Second overtime game of the night.
Lesson learned. We know he's left-handed. You can't mirror the ball. You got to make sure his vision is almost, I hate to say that, use the word impaired, but you've got to block his line of sight in that particular shot. I know we don't want to foul, but you give the opportunity to hit that shot, and he made it.
I know. You know he had to have told him, whatever you do, don't foul him. I mean, you know, the odds of him making that shot are not very good, but they did. And the thing that's amazing about this, you kept saying they're going to pull one off. They're going to pull one off. But the way they've been playing their games the past, what, five, six games, holding the ball, keeping it under 40 points for the winning team. So not as much surprised that they picked one of these teams off, but 65-61, that's not the way I thought they would do it.
All right, so I agree to disagree on a few things. One point, yes, we've tested the waters on that. Mr. Producer, we're going to have to check and see what I said in that. I'm pretty sure that I said they're going to pull the upset in the tournament, but they pulled an upset here. That bothers me
a
little bit.
That
bothers me a little bit because I'm superstitious, but let me just let you in. I'm not going to show my hand. We've showed our hand a little bit early. We know that we're going to keep this thing low. They didn't. They came out here and they scored 65 points to win this game. So what does that tell you? We're going to have our first round game. Are we going to come out? We're going to run and gun. Are we going to hold it?
It goes back to holding.
I'd say that we're going to hold it. So guess what Ravenwood's going to be working on all week?
Holding it.
Holding the ball. So be interested to see how this plays out.
Who knows? Maybe they come out and it's run and gun.
Hey, man. If it's run and gun.
Creekwood, five around the arc.
If they run and gun, I don't know. I still think they can play spoiler. And this matchup right here is extremely – I'm not sure there could be a better draw for them right now than Ravenwood. I just – they came off the big win for Summit. This is kind of one of those hangover situations where it's a trap game. We're going to walk through this deal. Not so fast.
Well, and – if they can't, this one's not at Centennial. This one's going to be at Ravenwood. So if they by chance could, now they've got home court advantage. But you're right. But we'll get to that.
Franklin Rebels coach Joins 15-8, 6-4, lost two in a row. Brentwood lost to Brentwood 68-54, 64. Centennial 65-61. They have the number five seed. Coach Joins has talked about it all year. Man, we could go from second to fifth in a heartbeat. And guess what happened? They went from second to fifth in literally two games.
Yeah, and he knew what he was talking about. But again, end up fifth. The thing about them is if they're hitting those threes, they can beat anybody in this district. I would not want to see them in the tournament.
I would not want to see who they're going to be facing in the 4-5 game, and that would be the Independence Eagles. Right now, Murphy playing as good as basketball as anybody in the state. Travesty that he's not on. I'm going to say it publicly. It is an absolute travesty that he is not on the Mr. Basketball AAA finalist. That is unbelievable. His overall body work, 1,854 points. He's talking about topping out at possibly hitting the 2,000-point mark if they can advance and go on. It's just mind-blowing to me. That's another argument for another day. 16-10, 7-5. They have won 5 in a row. They lost 6 in a row. They were dead in the water. They're back in it. They beat Dixon 69-54. They've got the number 4 seed.
And playing with a lot of confidence right now.
Absolutely. We've got to be brief. Ravenwood, 19-6, 7-5. They beat Summit 64-59 in a huge game Friday to put themselves in position in the number 3 seed to avoid that 4-5 game. And don't think he wasn't thinking about it. I'll take my chance with Centennial any day versus Murphy or the hot shooting Franklin.
Without a doubt. It was a game Coach Whitlock said they had to have it. Obviously, he relayed that message to the team. Big win.
Interesting note, Elon Smallwood eclipses 1,000 points in that game.
Jaden
Lewis on the Summit side eclipses 1,000 points. Never, we're trying to check the record books. Don't think that's ever happened in a game in the WCS Sports Conference before. Summit finishes 21-5 in the regular season, 10-2. Beat Centennial 40-35, but they did lose to Ravenwood. They've lost 3 out of the last 4. Doesn't bode well, but I'm telling you, they are limping right now. They're going to get themselves back. They've got almost 5 days. They're going to have 6 days of getting rested and getting ready before their second round matchup.
You know, I don't think they would publicly say this. They knew they had the number one seed wrapped up. They've had some tough games, a long season. Brentwood Academy is one of these they lost. If I'm Summit, I'm not that worried about the loss 3 out of the 4 to finish. I'm more concerned, and what I'm harping on is the 21 wins before those 5 losses.
Fairview, 12-13, 8-8, lost to Lewis County, 61-58. Lost to Lewis County a second time in a row, 72-62. They finish in the number 4 seed, and guess who they have to play? Lewis County again. That'll be the third time in a week that they have to play them to survive and advance. Coach Jarrett Jones done a great job.
Great job.
Got the team above 500. There's no way. Put it right here, Mr. Producer. No way Lewis County beats them 3 times in a row.
I hope you're right.
Page, 13-10, 6-5. Coach Larry No beat Nolensville 54-50. They're at Giles County, will be number 4 seed. Probably have to play Giles County again. Superstition always lends to the side of whoever loses that game, turns around and wins that district tournament game. So we'll see how that plays out for them. Nolensville 8-16, 2-9, have lost 9 in a row. Young. But they have a great opportunity to play spoiler. If they can get their minds right, that team right there is going to be dangerous, not only this year, but next year and 2 years to come. The Knights are going to be in the 7th seed.
Yep. Marshall County is going to be tough. But, the CPA game, they were down by 2 with 3 minutes left the first time they played them. Second time, not so much. Same thing with Marshall County. They've proven they can play with these guys, but it's going to take – we play 4 quarters in basketball, right? Not 3.
4 quarters. All right, here we go. Rundown of the District 11 AAA Tournament. This will be at the higher seed on Wednesday, February the 15th. Independence, number 4 seed, will go in and play number 5 at Franklin. Hosting that, Andy, winner gets Summit in the wings. What do you have?
I think you got to give, and this is
a big statement. We're running out of time. I know that. Good, because I'm not going to be able to
pick. I think you got to give Joins Coach of the Year, so no slight against him, and that's a big statement. I think Independence. Grayson Murphy, best player.
Unfortunately, we're out of time. Brentwood plays Dixon 2-7. Brentwood hosts Dixon. Ravenwood hosts Centennial. We'll have to just see how it
makes it. Why don't you tweet these picks?
Oh, all right. That's a deal. I'll give you that. We'll tweet these picks. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time on Sports Connection. We'll be right back.